I'm Steph Stricklen with GeekWire Studios here at AWS reInvent 2025. When we all have an opportunity to come together in a space like this, we really see what is at the cutting edge of AI. And that's what we're going to talk about today. I've got two guests I want to introduce you to right now. The first is Carrie Chiu, the General Manager, DevSecOps, Data and AI at NBN, as well as Jen Jackson with Accenture. Ladies, thank you so much for making the time today.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
Carrie, my first question is for folks who don't know, what is NBN?
So NBN is National Broadband Network. We are based in Australia. We connect to, you know, the whole Australians to provide broadband services. We are a wholesaler. So 81% of the internet traffic going through our network in Australia.
We will talk a little bit in a minute about the partnership between Accenture and NBN, but I want to start with a question for you, Carrie, that's talking about something that is professionally important to you, and that is creating this inclusive incubation environment that really can bring together Gen AI as well as agentic AI innovation in the space, experimentation, learning, all of those things coming together. How do you do that and also manage security standards and everything else that happens in a regulated industry?
Yeah, so from my team and myself, we believe incubation or innovation doesn't sit in a central team. We believe that it should be federated to the SMEs that sit in the business area where they're facing the problem every day, so they understand how to solve the problem using the tools we provide. How do we do that? So we have we create a safe SMP environment. The platform is called RSMBN. We've done a lot of security, embedding security control and also adversarial testing to make sure that it is safe to use, and we comply with the responsible AI policies as well. So that gives us confidence to provide this environment and tooling for not just internally in IT environment, but also to our business to self-serve. We understand that this technology has lowered the barrier for entry for people to use this kind of technique to solve the problem using other possible to reimagining how they will do this work. And so this has been a really fantastic opportunity for us to provide this capability for our broader, I would say, citizen development team. So we actually launched a citizen development initiative in NBN about 12 months ago. We start with 15 people, and now we scale to 650 people. And they'll learn about how to use this technology to build assistance and to learn this technology, how to use Gen AI and building agents, simple agents today.
From a development at scale to maybe knowledge at scale, Accenture comes into this discussion because what you really bring is a wide berth of knowledge to help a company like NBN, small partners, large partners. Where does Accenture fit into this piece?
You know, we've been impressed with teams like Carrie's team because they're really leading the way. And we recently did some research because we were trying to figure out why there are teams like Carrie's that do very well and others that are not. And we found there's like four things that a company must do to be able to really thrive. And a lot of them Carrie's talked about. So she's a perfect model for how you should operate. And a lot of that is having a foundational data layer, having a long-term plan, having responsible AI, and then empowering people. Because Carrie and I were just talking about this, you know, having a COE is important, having a structure is important, having those four layers are in place, but then really to scale, you have to empower your people. And that is where the successful companies we see are doing. It is not about controlling anymore. It's setting the standards, having your foundational elements, and then empowering people to scale.
So it's interesting that we're talking about the human power factor in all of this, but I'm also curious how NBN manages this hybrid of these traditional applications and maybe the traditional way of approaching those against what we're seeing right now, AI native applications, agentic AI. How do you balance that?
Yeah, so I mean, as Riley pointed out, I think we're gonna be in a hybrid world for a long time, probably forever. You know, we're looking at today, maybe 1% of application, less than 1% of application is AI native. 99.9% is actually traditional way of building applications. And we need to understand the differences between the two. So traditionally, when you build applications, you spend a lot of time on requirement, design, and actually build. And because everything is deterministic, so your output, you can manage with a very consistent regression test suite, and also expectation of the operation area, you can really control that very well and with a well-known security control. But with AI native AI applications, it could be it can be variable, right? So we do find that you do get from requirement to solution to development very fast, but however, you get stuck on regression testing, you get stuck on reliability in terms of accuracy, and also challenges in production in terms of security as well. So from NBN point of view, we do put focus on the hardening of our platform and environment to make sure it's secure, make sure it is operational, make sure observability is in place. So it helps us to be more efficient and more effective in operating this environment in production. Data is very important. So another thing is around make sure the data is AI ready. So we've done quite a large program called Data Simplicity, which consolidating all of our legacy data platform, whether it's on-premise or whether it's scattering somewhere else, we consolidate into AWS, our data lake and Redshift. And it gives us a single source of truth, which allows us to, harnessing the power of Gen AI. But now when we're looking at the AI native application, we also understand that we need to make sure our data is actually AI ready as well. So it needs to provide semantic information. Relationship has become really important. So the AI agentic world can actually leverage these to be more autonomous.
So you've teed me up actually for a really fascinating theme that I'm seeing, especially as I talk to Accenture in this. You mentioned efficiency, you mentioned effectiveness, and really that comes down to being sort of a responsible AI leader as you start thinking about where your company's headed in that direction. What does Accenture bring to the partnership to help someone like Carrie and NBN achieve those goals?
Well, I think, Carrie and NBN is a leader in responsible AI, which is impressive, but I think you were an early leader. And, last year, we saw a need for more direction for our clients around responsible AI, more partnership. And we talked a lot about our clients around pillars of responsible AI and actually helping them with building the guardrails, having the governance, making sure, you're monitoring and continuously checking that, your data estate is following the guardrails that you put in place, how you're speaking to the board, how you're holding yourselves accountable. I think all of that, making sure that is set up, is what we enable all of our clients with. Because if you don't do that, many clients, they run ahead and they move too fast. Either the board pulls them back or they pull themselves back because they realize they've not put in the proper controls and they sometimes find, a result that they didn't expect. And so I think following the lead of teams like Carrie's and making sure you have all these components is what we bring to every AI project, because we don't like to get started until our clients are appropriately enabled.
Great answer. One of the things as I was reading through sort of your professional history is a focus on inclusivity, and this dovetails into a conversation we started having about AI several years ago, which is workforce displacement. How do you approach upskilling your workforce so that they are ready to move into sort of a new era of thinking about what it means to be employed in this digital era?
Yeah, so in NBN, we very much focus on our digital skills. And we have recently launched a university called Digital University, Ignite U. And it covers four faculties. So we've got security, data, AI, and automation. And these are the four key things that we believe that it's a critical skills for at a digital era. From AI point of view, responsible AI is actually one of the foundational course that everyone who sits in this university has to complete. And that allows us to at least understand a common language and have a basic level of literacy around what is AI, what's Gen AI, and what's Agentic AI. And from there, we have a full course of start from foundation all the way up to strategy and leadership and governance. So four levels of the course curriculum. And we have recently actually launched Activation Week. It's a bit like the old week in university, but we call them Activation Week. And in there, my team, mentioned earlier with the RSMBN and Pete, we actually launched a 15 minutes segment to say, we show you how to create an AI agent in 15 minutes. And we got so many people applying, about 218 people applied for two sessions. So it was really successful. And those are the things that we want to make it exciting and easy for people to understand and use, but at the same time, actually learn that as a skills and they can continue to use in their work.
Sign me up. I want to be the next person, 281. Ladies, thank you so much for your time today. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm Steph Stricklen. You've been watching GeekWire Studios.